Hello, this is the RPG Chick, and welcome to another edition of the Broodling Bulletins for July of 2015. I'm going to jump right into it. A few things. All good news this time. My new headset is back. Well, my replacement for the original. For those who don't know, I got a Sennheiser 323D, and, worked great, except when I would raise and lower the boom, you'd hear static and crackling sounds, and you'd also hear them randomly when I was playing a game and recording a few guys. It would actually record. So that was no good, so I ended up recording a whole bunch of episodes and getting a nice big backlog, and then I sent the headset back to be exchanged. Unfortunately, I did have to pay the return postage to get it back. They do have some sort of UPS discount. What's this? Sonic Electronics actually got it from. So what happened? Well, I don't have a printer to print out the label or anything like that. So I figured, well, let's just go normal U.S. Postal Service, and I just sent it normal mail that way. So what happened is they got it. It was only like 3 or 4 days later they sent me an email back saying they have received it, and they were going to send me another email stating, you know, in 1 or 2 days, stating that they were sending it back, what the, you know, the status of that was, and if they were sending it back, that they'd give me a tracking number. So I never got another email, but I did get it back. I ended up getting it back 6 days after I sent the thing out, which is pretty good because I sent it regular mail, not priority or anything. So they really, you know, stepped up the ball on this one. Unfortunately, I did have to pay extra to send the thing back. But you can hear I'm raising and lowering the boom here. You can hear it moving, of course, because that's normal. But there's no, you know, that there used to be. So I do have it back. It sounds much, much better. And I'm happy. Things are good. In other news, other good news, Google has announced that Google Plus will no longer be attached to YouTube. You can only imagine how surprised but delighted I was. People were, there was an uproar when they made this change, and I don't know, it was a while ago. Was it like 2 years ago? I don't even know. But it's been a while, and now they're saying people have told us that accessing all of their Google stuff with one account makes life a whole lot easier, but we've also heard that it doesn't make sense for your Google Plus profile to be your identity in all other Google products you use. Yeah, duh. We've been telling you that for years, but I guess better late than never. So the first change is that comments that you make on YouTube will only appear on YouTube, not on Google Plus as well, and vice versa. That's the change, and then in the coming weeks, you'll no longer need a profile at all to upload, comment, make a channel, or anything like that. But don't delete your Google Plus yet, because if you do so now, it will also delete your YouTube channel. So, yeah, don't do that. Just be happy the changes are coming, and be happy that you can already see some progress and we are moving forward from here. It's going to take them a while to reverse all the not well-founded choices they've made. One thing that I noticed, I did actually mention to one other person on Google Plus that I speak with sometimes, Kaiser. Hey Kaiser. That some of my videos were going, you know, across posting to Google Plus and some weren't. Namely, my Walking Dead videos, which were new, were cross posting to Google Plus, and my Pillars of Eternity uploads, you know, I schedule them in advance. What I think happened is that The Walking Dead, at the time, I had set so far in advance to upload that the changes hadn't occurred on those videos, meaning, you know, I had already set it you know, to upload like over a week later, and the change, the Google Plus setting to cross post was already in the code, so when it went live it posted on Google Plus. Meanwhile, the Pillars videos were newer. I, you know, was catching up. I was still building up the backlog to wait for my new headset to come. So the Pillars videos were newer, so those did not cross-post because they were more current. They didn't have the code locked in. So even though they made this change on the 27th, I think they had already been, changes had already been underway. So that's why that happens. But what's funny, yeah, right now my videos for Walking Dead 400 Days are cross-posting, yeah, but still the Pillars aren't, and the Game of Thrones weren't. Those were brand new because that had uploaded last, that had, the new episode was available Tuesday of last week, and I had uploaded, I had recorded them and uploaded them. So yeah, that's what I think, but it really doesn't matter. You know, they're all gonna stop cross-posting. If the Season 2 Walking Dead videos cross-post to Google+, then obviously they haven't done their job, because I just started playing that last night. In other news, I am probably trying to get a new graphics card, the GeForce GTX 970. I really want to get the 980. I really want to get the 980 Ti, but I just can't afford it. I don't have $500 to just order a graphics card. You know, I'd have to save for months probably to do that, because every time I seem to save a little money, something happens and I have to use it on something. So I'm going to be getting the 970, thinking about getting it from EVGA, maybe one of the overclocked ones. The FTW for the Win version would be nice, and I think I'm not getting that, and well, I'm working towards getting that, and since I have, I'll have one of the newer graphics cards, NVIDIA graphics cards out there, I can use Shadowplay instead of Fraps, like I have been. Now the quality of, like, the basic quality of the video, you know, the, when you look at things, the textures and the details and the lighting and everything like that, I think takes a little bit of a hit, but it really makes no, hardly any impact, like 3 to 5 frames per second difference, minus 20% like I get now from Fraps. So, and takes up a lot less disk space. What I want to do is get, you know, an SSD drive or two, and if I get Fraps, if I want to save onto an SSD drive with Fraps, it's going to have to be a 1TB SSD drive, and saving large chunks of files and basically deleting them, writing over them, deleting them, writing over them, your SSD runs out a lot quicker than your hard, normal, you know, hard disk drive would. So I'm thinking of playing around with Shadowplay. I have heard some problems with glitches and artifacts on the screen. Some people have them, some people don't have them. I've heard problems with audio clipping just dropping out after like 12 minutes or so. That happens to some people, doesn't happen to others. It might depend on what kind of graphics card you're using with it. Because the reason it takes hardly any FPS hit is it's using hardware on the graphics card itself to encode real-time these videos, which will not put any strain on your hard disk drive or anything like that while you're playing the game, which would slow everything down. So, and it's also, since it's encoding, it's not saving as raw, you know, video footage. So instead of taking up for a half an hour video, taking like, could be anywhere up to 160 gigs per half hour, would take, I don't know, under 10 gigs. So yeah, I do want to play with that. I'll make a test video or two, and then have to keep an eye on it. We'll see from there. In other good news, I have a new record for the channel as far as views, slightly. New record is 22,815 views for the month, up from 22,473 versus 22,815. So this is my new world record for the channel. Likes were very nice as well. I got 508 likes, and so it's good. Things are good. We'll see if we can beat it again this month. We'll see what we can do. I've been getting a lot of hits on the Walking Dead series, including the 400 days. Really enjoyed the game. Without any spoilers, just gotta say that ending floored me. That's all I'm gonna say. For anyone who hasn't seen it, you know, maybe not look at the comments in case someone gives it away. You know, but, well, it is a game from 2012, you know, but just in case you guys haven't played it. Yeah, very worth playing. One of my favorite games of all time now, I believe. And just started playing 400 Days. I just played that, you know, right before I sent these headphones away. I played that one. That was very enjoyable. I felt it was kind of hard to get into the characters. Really just a brief intro to these characters and then boom, on to the next thing. So it was interesting. It's something that could have easily been expanded into, you know, four episodes rather than one single hour and a half episode, which is even short for the typical Telltale game episode. Speaking of an hour and a half episodes, Game of Thrones, which I played, was only an hour and a half, but they packed a lot into that hour and a half, and it is the penultimate chapter of this Game of Thrones, the complete game. And again, that ending, they left us with this choice that was impossible to make. And you guys can discuss it in the comments, I'll discuss it with you, or you can go to the video and discuss it there. I feel like no matter which decision I made, it was good yet bad. I really can't say, but it was really, really good episode. I noticed right away without even looking at the time that it's over. Anyway, back to The Walking Dead. Yes, Telltale Games. Up the wazoo here. Walking Dead Season 2. Just started playing it. Please, no spoilers here or in the game otherwise. Really enjoying it so far. I'm noticing that the controls are different. Just the interface. There are some differences with the interface. But I'm having a lot of fun playing it and looking forward to getting to know these characters that we're being introduced to. You know, I'm sure there's a lot more than meets the eye to these characters. Not a happy world. I do enjoy playing in it. I'm fascinated by everything post-apocalyptic to begin with. Whether it has zombies or not, zombies just sweeten the deal to me. It's more like it's an escape from this world, but I'd rather live in this world, believe me. The things that these people go through, it just makes me appreciate my own life even that much more. So I'm gonna shut up about that. Pillars of Eternity is moving along slowly because we're investigating the city of Defiance Bay. So yeah, there's a lot of reading. There's a lot of, you run into NPCs and you get to read their history and stuff like that. I read everything. So I should maybe put a disclaimer on my channel somewhere. I read everything because I guess I wouldn't blame some people get bored, you know, you skip ahead in the video. And I was thinking of putting, you know, links to skip, you know, but there's just so many instances. I mean, I don't want to do that. I don't want to spend hours making links to skip all these videos when a lot of people are probably watching on mobile anyway and they can't use or even see the annotations. And I'd rather just play the game, have fun, record, upload it, you know, spend my time doing things to improve the channel. So I like the Andrew's Gift the most so far because there are some battles, there are some interesting NPCs, there's a brothel. It's one of the first places we go to look, and you know, then we go into the water and we get attacked, and then we end up fighting these bandits who are harassing everybody because they don't like the brothel. So it's pretty interesting in this quests, and you know, we do run into a new player character, a new, well, NPC that joins our party. This character is pretty freaking awesome. At least that's for my tastes. Yeah, awesome. Very, very intrigued. And I have yet to explore this character some more. I have to actually talk to this character some more and find out some of the background, you know, because I did forget momentarily that when you have a new character enter your party, you could just start talking to them and asking them about everything. So that's pretty awesome. I'm really enjoying Pillars of Eternity. Looking forward to the DLC, The White March Part 1, meaning there's going to be more than one. So I'm looking forward to that, even though I don't think I've even advanced that far into the main quest. So speaking of change the channel, my new logo, I made this little RPG chick out of clip art I found. That chick is Easter theme clip art that you can use to make crafts with the kids and such like that. So I gave her a helmet and a sword, and she's ready to go. Other than that, everything's the same, well, except for the background. I had no background. It was white before. And I have this dungeon corridor maze background here. And my logo I did have is another logo. I'll show you what it used to look like, but I've actually been using this logo on my videos for quite some time, and I just never got around to changing the banner. So while I was not recording LPs and missing recording LPs, I was doing stuff like this. That is that. Thanks for watching, and see you in the Let's Plays.